गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द सेक्शंस ऑफ TDS रेलिवेंट टू NGOs हैव बीन कवर्ड बाय मी इन माय ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज ऑन TDS. आई होप विद दीज ट्यूटोरियल्स यू ऑल मस्ट हैव नाउ अ बेटर क्लैरिटी एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ डिडक्शन प्रोसेस, लिमिट्स एंड रेट्स ऑफ TDS अंडर डिफरेंट सेक्शंस ऑफ द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट. इन दिस वीडियो we shall be discussing the consequences of non-deduction or untimely deposit of TDS amount and related returns. The consequences on failure to comply with the provisions of TDS as laid down in different sections of the Act can be divided into three parts: interest, late fee or penalty, and disallowance of expenditure as application of income. So let's discuss the provisions for each of these consequences as laid down in the Act. First comes interest on delay in payment of TDS or non-deduction of TDS. So interest shall be levied on both non-payment of TDS or delay in payment of TDS and non-deduction of TDS also. As per section 201, if any person who is liable to deduct tax at source does not deduct it, or after so deducting fails to pay the whole or any part of the tax to be credit of the government, then such person shall be liable to pay interest at the rate of 1% for every month or part of the month on amount of such tax from the date on which such tax was deductible to the date on which such tax was actually deducted. I repeat, interest at the rate 1% has to be paid for every month or even part of the month on the amount of such tax from the date on which such tax was deductible to the date on which such tax was actually deducted. Apart from this, interest at the rate of 1.5% also shall be levied for every month or part of the month on the amount of such tax from the date on which such tax was deducted to the date on which such tax was actually remitted to the credit of the government. I repeat, interest at the rate of 1.5% shall also be levied for every month or part of the month on the amount of such tax from the date on which the tax was deducted to the date on which such tax was paid to the credit of the government. In other words, interest is levied in two parts. First, 1% for the delay in deduction, which shall be calculated up to the date of deduction, and then 1.5% for delay in payment after the deduction, which shall be calculated from the date of deduction to the date of actual payment. Now comes the second part, late fee or penalty on non-filing of TDS returns. As per section 234E, where a person fails to file the TDS return on or before the due date prescribed in this regard, then he shall be liable to pay by way of fee a sum of ₹200 for every day during which the failure continues. My goodness, ₹200 per day. Isn't it too much? Not really, because there is a cap on such fees. The amount of late fees shall not exceed the amount of TDS. This implies a maximum late fee for late filing of TDS that one has to pay is 100% of the TDS amount. Apart from such late fees, minimum penalty can also be levied by the assessing officer amounting ₹10,000, which can go up to ₹1,00,000. Remember, penalty under section 271H will be in addition to late filing fees prescribed under section 234E. However, no penalty under section 271H will be levied in case of delay in filing of TDS return if following conditions are satisfied. The tax deducted or collected at source is paid to the credit of the government. Late filing fees and interest is paid to the credit of the government.
the return is filed before the expiry of a period of 1 year from the due date as prescribed for such filing. So penalty shall not be levied if all your dues are paid and the return is filed before the expiry of a period of 1 year from the due date as prescribed for such filing. Now comes the third part, disallowance of expenditure. As per section 40, subclause IA, 30% of such expenditure shall not be allowed as an application of income in that particular year in three of the following cases. That is, in case of non-deduction of whole of the tax, in case of non-deduction of any part of the tax, which implies even cases of short deduction of TDS is also covered, or in case of non-payment of tax to the central government within the time limit prescribed under section 139(1), that is due date of filing income tax returns after deducting the same from the pay. However, in case the deduction on such payment is made in any subsequent year or is paid after the due date as prescribed under section 139(1), the balance of 30% expenditure which was not allowed in the year of non-compliance shall be allowed in such subsequent year in which the compliance is met. I repeat, in case the deduction on such payment is made in any subsequent year or is paid even after the due date as prescribed under section 139(1), the balance 30% expenditure which was not allowed in the year of non-compliance shall be allowed in such subsequent year in which the compliance has been met. So, the organizations failing to comply with the TDS provisions need to not only pay interest and penalty but also have to bear the burden of extra taxation by way of lesser application of income due to disallowance of such amount paid on which the tax was not deducted or deducted but was not paid. The compliance chart, including various due dates for TDS payment and filing of TDS returns with statutory compliances, can be found on our website and Facebook page. The link of the same is also given in the description below. Thank you for your patient listening. For any queries or clarifications, feel free to contact us through email or comment below. Thank you.